When I first arrived to Miami, one of the first places that I stopped by was Plant the Future. Plant the Future is like a sanctuary full of beautiful cacti and plants that just play with this very special ceramics. And it really conquered my heart since the beginning. And when I had first arrived and I didn't really know Miami, for me it was like, yes, there's hope. There's people that think creatively in this city. So right now you're gonna see my interview with Paloma Tepa from Plant the Future. This was part of the series that I created for a journalistic project with GoDaddy, and I think you're gonna love her story. So this is one of the interviews that I've been looking forward to the most ever since I arrived to Miami. This is Plant the Future. Paloma Tepa's baby. This is Paloma, the inspiring woman behind this. And she has a very important mission in this life, and I really want you to hear more about it.
My mission?
About your mission. Tell me.
My mission, I feel that I'm like a protector of plants. And my mission is to connect people with nature, and so they can, I'm like the bridge to that connection, and I dress them as a party so they can look beautiful and they can see them better.
Like I look today.
Exactly. And yeah, my mission is they are so sweet, and we can learn so many beautiful things from them. So it's a very powerful message and so inspiring for me to give every day having this mission in life.
What is the most special moment of your day?
Favorite
part?
Of course, is when I'm touching the soil. They ground me, they give me love. When I see the plants, I can, when connecting and talking with them. They're givers, they're pure givers of love and good energy. You don't know nothing else than that. And so be surrounded to plants. They can cure your soul, they can cure your mind, they can give you peace. There are so many, it's heaven in life. So imagine how as much, I have more plants in my home than furniture. I want
your
to live with less things and have more plants.
And what inspired it all? What's the story behind this place?
My daughter Emeline is my main inspiration as a designer. I study industrial design, and as an industrial designer, my goal, my mission, my inspiration is to design a world for her. And this is what I see as the most sweetest and beautiful and loving place. Be surrounded in nature and plants. We live in a city in Miami. It's a very big city, growing. And yeah, it's the way that I find to feel nature. Mm-hmm. Yes.
Yeah, I'm reading you. I'm like, yes. Mm-hmm. I wanted to ask you as well. So, how did it start though? What were the obstacles you encountered? Because it's not easy to tell someone, yeah, I'm gonna sell cactus.
I think the limitations were myself and my mind, and with a lot of things that I learned from the society and my country, where my family and everything that it was around me, that was telling me that I just had an opportunity just if I was a lawyer or a doctor or an engineer. And I think there are many, many opportunities for anybody who can find the mission and why we are here in this world. And yeah, my mind was maybe the biggest obstacle that I every day I work to with her, okay, to be out of the box, trying to do a difference, trying to do a better person. In this moment of my life, I'm like rethinking everything that I learned when I was a child. I'm trying to redesign everything. I think that we need to be, and we are, in a new consciousness, and mm-hmm. And that's what I want to be very focused and concentrated to be feeling my soul, to understand why I'm in this world.
What would be your biggest advice for someone who also wants to find that in their lives, to find their mission? What's the biggest?
Yeah, I think that it's good to be alone for terms of time, so you can really go through yourself, your mind, your soul, your heart, and talk to yourself, you know, because we have a lot of information from all around, so that's sometimes kind of confusing, and we really need to understand that we have just one fingerprint. Every single of us, we are different, and we are here for something special, and we are not a coincidence of the world. We are here because we have a purpose, and we need to find that purpose, and in that is the best way to find it is in silence, talking with yourself, as the plants talk in silence.
That's exactly what I was thinking. And how do you define success?
Success is to have peace, to have free time, to have quiet moments in silence. Success is to feel a lot of love, to give as much as we can, and I think that comes to give. We need to. We are here to. That's what I learn from nature. Every day, I'm here to give. I don't have. It will be not another reason that I'm here living, breathing, if it's not to give to others.
So that's your. And what is it that you want now? What do you want this brand to become?
And that's why I love the Century, and the company's, yes, is growing, very successful, but to be honest, that's not my focus. My focus is to design, now it's not just a plan, now I need to design spaces, sanctuaries that are bigger, and we can give more impact, not just for one person, it's for a community. So I'm dreaming to do this bigger in terms of space, to more people to come and enjoy and reconnect with nature, reconnect with themselves, and I dream in a better life for everybody, surrounded of love and plants.
You need to experience this to understand what she's saying, because when you're in the outside life, I guess we all forget, even for me. So thank you very much, Paloma. Wonderful talking to you.
Thank you.
Ay, eres una belleza. Gracias, mi niña linda. Perfecto.